What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining me on another FCP Euro DIY. Today we are working on a 2018 Volvo XC90. Today on this T5 XC90, we are going to be covering how to replace your PCV system. This kit includes a couple of the lines, a new oil cap, the PCV valve, and the diaphragm. This should be a pretty straightforward DIY and something we recommend you do every 50,000 miles or so. While the system on these newer direct injected engines is a bit better than the traditional systems known to the past, five-cylinder engines, pretty much anything from like the late 90s to the direct injected motors, these do still need to be serviced. Again, every 50,000 miles is what we recommend, in order to avoid having a stuck diaphragm or a failed valve, which can lead to high crank pressure in the engine, causing oil leaks, and in extreme cases, blowing out seals like your rear main seal or front main seal. So definitely something you wanna avoid. What can you do to mitigate this in the meantime? Staying on top of your oil changes every 5,000 miles at most. This should be a straightforward DIY, but before we get into it, let's take a look at some of the tools we're gonna need. All right, for this DIY, we have a 3/8 drive ratchet and its electric counterpart. We have some pliers, a flathead screwdriver, a 21 mil socket, an 8 mil socket, a T40, a T25, and a large 3-inch extension. Now we know what we're working with, let's go ahead and get started. All right, let's start by getting our beauty cover off. Four T40s, they're just little plastic screws that hold this. Next, we're gonna take out the air box. We're gonna start with that. That's gonna be the more tedious part of this DIY. It'll still be very simple. We have an electrical connector for our sensor right here. Just gonna push the little tab to release. And then we have an alligator clip right here holding on the harness that we're gonna pry out with our screwdriver so that this is free from the airbox. With the same flathead, let's undo our hose clamp for the airbox. And now we have six T25s around the airbox to undo so we can get that lid off. Can lift this baby up, twist that out, pull this out. Great time to check the filter. And then we're gonna pull out the bottom half of the box, which is held on by two rubber grommets, then it keys into a little duct in the front and one underneath. The one underneath is gonna be more tedious to deal with when we put it back together, but that's a problem for a future mic. We'll show you how to do it. We're just gonna lift up from the front, from the back, pull up and away. Here's that bottom ducting, which I was telling you about, but we'll show you how to do that later. Now with this to the side, we can work on getting to the PCV valve, which is gonna be located under here. It's actually pretty straightforward to get to. It's a little bit hidden, but we'll show you where it is. And then the line that goes to it, we'll swap those two out and then we'll move on to the easier bit up top. Here's our lower PCV line. We have a little T that just holds it here. Not a big deal right now. We have two release tabs, one on either side. This is gonna be a little bit tedious to get to. You should be able to rotate it though so that they're up and down. And then you can get your fingers in here, pull back and pull the line off. Following that line, it goes underneath the intake boot. A little T here separates it or helps keep it in line. And then we have another connection with a quick release. That one has a 90 degree elbow to the intake boot. So we'll go ahead and pop that one off next. Here's our old line out. Remember, the 90 goes to the intake boot. Now let's get our PCV valve out. For that, we're gonna use our 21 millimeter socket and our 3-inch extension. And here is our old valve. Still looks okay. Now let's thread our new one in. Make sure we start it by hand, obviously. I don't know how else you would do it, but nonetheless, should go without saying. Now we have a couple threads on. Let's go back in with the 21 and we're just snugging this up. Once it feels a little bit taut and the thread sealant on the threads is doing its thing, we can stop. That feels good. Now we can get our new line in. We'll start at the intake. Just pop that in. Again, 90 degree elbow. We have our little fitting down below. Want to hear a little click. There we go. Give it a little bit of a pull. Should be good to rock. Feed it back into its little clip there. And then onto the valve. Beautiful. All right. Let's get the airbox back in now. Let's feed our airbox in. We're going to be reaching through the front hole of the box here to help lift up this ducting, which is going to allow us to sit onto this lower ducting. Kind of a not great design. Makes it a little bit tedious to get an airbox in, something that should be nice and simple, but nonetheless, that's the way to do it. Get our filter and lid back on. Let's get our sensor plugged back in and our little alligator clamp that holds our wiring harness in place on the lid of the airbox. And now we can get our clamp situated once more with our flathead screwdriver. With that buttoned up, let's move over to the oil separator and our other line. Whenever you're doing any work on your engine that's gonna cause it to be open to the elements, taking some time to brake clean and hit the area with some compressed air as well, or either or, is gonna go a long way. We had a pretty big nest on here before. We just kind of brake cleaned around it. We still have to do another job later, which is going to require even more cleaning, which is why it's still a little messy under here. For now, we're just focused on this area around the oil separator. This vacuum line is going to come off the inlet tube up top here. We should be able to just pull it up. And I'm going to leave it attached to this, but it comes out really easy. The new one comes new and improved with clamps, something a little bit different. All right. We have a series of 8mm bolts around the separator. Let's go ahead and zap those out. All right, let's get our new diaphragm on top. I'm gonna throw my new oil cap too, which is part of this, on now. Oh yeah, fresh. If you're gonna torque these down, no more than 10 Newton meters. It's not a lot. We're just gonna gently drive them in with the electric ratchet in a crisscross pattern. That's gonna go something like that. We're gonna feed it onto the inlet pipe first. We should be able to bully our way through the clamp without having to use the pliers, but we have them just in case. Bam, baby. Let's get the beauty cover on. Let's wrap up this DIY. Cover lined up, whack-a-mole. All four plastic T40s. And we are done, my good people. You are set for another 50,000 miles. Overall, a really straightforward job on these newer direct injected four cylinders. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave those in the comment section below. And if you like this DIY and you'd like to see more like them, consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you for watching. I'll catch you on the next one.